Good morning, children. Today we'll discuss about the remaining part of the measurement lesson. In the last class, we have discussed about gram, kg, liter, and milliliters, and the standard measures used for measuring liquids. Today we'll learn about time and distances and how to measure that. Distances are measured in millimeter, centimeter, meter and kilometer. Height, length, width and distances are measured using these measuring scales or units. Long distances are measured in kilometers. Our clothes are measured in centimeters using the measuring tape. And small lengths like pencil, erasers, length of book, these are measured using scale and centimeter scale and is used to measure the length of these objects. And millimeter is used to measure the length of very small objects like bacteria, viruses, etc. 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. Millimeter is the smallest unit of distance. Whether it may be measured, used to measure width, length or height. Millimeter is the smallest unit and 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter and 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter and 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. Kilometer is the longest distance and bigger than that is meter and then centimeter and very smallest is millimeter. Okay, our height is measured in feet and inches. And children, in earlier days, height, width and length is used to measure in, they used to measure these in feet and inches. But now all over the world, metric system is being accepted as the standard unit. There is one more activity for you all in the page number 129 and the activity is write what is being measured in each case, height or length. They have given images and arrows which shows height and length. We have to write there whether height is measured or length is measured in the images. For example, first one is window. And here height is measured. Find the remaining and write down and send me. And children, these are the instruments used for measuring length, width and height. In early times, there were no tape and scale. They used to measure the length using their body parts like hand and leg. But these are not standard units because width, height and length will be different in different people. These units are cubit, hand span, foot span and fathom. The length of hand, leg, arm will be different for different people. The length will be different. So these are not considered as standard units. Ruler, measuring tapes, measuring scales, these are considered as standard units. And children, we measure time with the help of clock or watch. And nowadays, we are using mobiles also to know the time. The standard unit of time is seconds. The standard unit of time is seconds. And 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. And 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. 60 minutes make 1 hour and 60 seconds will make 1 minute and we measure the time using the clock or watch. Children, when you fall sick or when you get fever, you will go to doctor. Yes, and doctor uses this instrument to measure your body temperature and this instrument is called thermometer. This instrument is used to measure the body temperature and the unit of temperature is degree Celsius, that is 0 C or degree Fahrenheit. Then children, why do we measure things? Measurement is very important in our daily life, because without measurement we will not get the exact or proper amount or quantity of things or the quality of things. Whether it is cooking or building houses or in making toothpaste or in buying or selling the things, we need to measure each and every thing or item, and we need this measurement in our daily life. Measurement requires tools and provides scientists with the quantity. A quantity describes how much of something is there or how many are there. A good example for measurement is using a ruler to find the length of an object. We measure things because if we never measure things, we would not know how far to go to a destination or how heavy you are and what time it is. See children, if you wanted to make a building and we make it 5 meter instead of 5 kilometer, then the building would be too small. Yes, so we need to measure the things to know its quality, distance, quantity, how much, how more we need. These all things are very important to measure. Okay, so children, complete the activity which I have given from the page number 129 and send. Thank you.